Would the F-35 win against a Russian Su-35? The Suhoi Su-35 Flanker E is the top Russian air superiority fighter in service today, and represents the pinnacle of fourth-generation jet fighter design. It will remain so until Russia succeeds in bringing its fifth-generation PAK-FA stealth fighter into production. Distinguished by its unrivaled maneuverability, most of the Su-35's electronics and weapons capabilities have caught up with those of Western equivalents, like the F-15 Eagle. But while it may be a deadly adversary to F-15s, Eurofighters and Rafales, the big question mark remains how effectively it can contend with fifth-generation stealth fighters such as the F-22 and F-35. The Flanker family of aircraft is supermaneuverable, meaning it is engineered to perform controlled maneuvers that are impossible through regular aerodynamic mechanisms. In the Su-35, this is in part achieved through use of thrust vectoring engines. The nozzles of its Saturn AL-41F1S turbofans can independently point in different directions in flight to assist the aircraft in rolling and yawing. Only one operational Western fighter, the F-22 Raptor, has similar technology. This also allows the Su-35 to achieve very high angles of attack. In other words, the plane can be moving in one direction while its nose is pointed in another. A high angle of attack allows an aircraft to more easily train its weapons on an evading target and execute tight maneuvers. Such maneuvers may be useful for evading missiles or dogfighting at close ranges, though they leave any aircraft in a low energy state. The Flanker E can achieve a maximum speed of Mach 2.25 at high altitude, equal to the F-22 and faster than the F-35 or F-16, and has excellent acceleration. However, contrary to initial reports, it appears it may not be able to supercruise, perform sustained supersonic flight without using afterburners, while loaded for combat. Its service ceiling is 60,000 feet, on par with F-15s and F-22s, and 10,000 feet higher than Super Hornets, Rafales and F-35s. The Su-35 has expanded fuel capacity, giving it a range of 2,200 miles on internal fuel, or 2,800 miles with two external fuel tanks. Both the lighter titanium airframe and the engines have significantly longer life expectancies than their predecessors, at 6,000 and 4,500 flight hours, respectively. For comparison, the F-22 and F-35 are rated at 8,000 hours. The Flanker airframe is not particularly stealthy. However, adjustments to the engine inlets and canopy, and the use of radar-absorbent material, supposedly halve the Su-35's radar cross-section. One article claims it may be down to between 1 and 3 meters. This could reduce the range it can be detected and targeted, but the Su-35 is still not a stealth fighter. The Su-35 has 12 to 14 weapons hardpoints, giving it an excellent loadout compared to the 8 hardpoints on the F-15C and F-22, or the 4 internally stowed missiles on the F-35. At long range, the Su-35 can use K-77M radar-guided missiles, known by NATO as the AA-12 Adder, which are claimed to have range of over 120 miles. For shorter-range engagements, the R-74, NATO designation, AA-11 Archer infrared-guided missile is capable of targeting, off-boresight, simply by looking through a helmet-mounted optical sight. The pilot can target an enemy plane up 60 degrees away from where his plane is pointed. The R-74 has a range of over 25 miles, and also uses thrust vectoring technology. The medium-range R-27 missile and the extra-long-range R-37, aka the AA-13 Arrow, for use against AWACs, EU and tanker aircraft, complete the Su-35's air-to-air missile selection. Additionally, the Su-35 is armed with a 30mm cannon with 150 rounds for strafing or dogfighting. The Flanker E can also carry up to 17,000 pounds of air-to-ground munitions. Historically, Russia has made only limited use of precision-guided munitions, PGMs, compared to Western air forces. However, the capability for large-scale use of such weapons is there, if doctrine and munition stocks accommodate it.